All right. Are we ready? Is everybody fully caffeinated? Okay. I am going to switch now. I've been using my mouse up until now. I'm going to use my tablet. You can use your mouse for this. It's just going to be easier for you to use a tablet. If you want to use both, that's cool. You know, I'm a lefty, so I have my stylus in my left hand on my tablet, and I got my mouse in my right hand because the world's mouses are prejudiced against lefties, much like school desks. I remember my right hand always had an armrest. My left hand never did. All right, who's ready to get into it? Okay, we talked about what's going on our property panels. You might have something different here. You might have the default setting, so there could already be three or four different layers here. And that's fine. You can keep those if you want to. You don't have to if you don't want to. You might already have a couple of default preset materials here as well. I got rid of those just in case you're not coming at this from the default settings and you don't see them. So we're going to create some materials and we're going to create some layers. And layers work exactly as you think they do. And to illustrate that point, let's just drive that home. So we have, okay, there's a black mark right there. Now, on this layer right here, you can have a bunch of different materials, and the layer of the material will have precedence on the layer, and that's totally fine. Let's create another layer. We'll call this layer 2. This is just for experiment, and so you can see what I'm talking about. Okay, layer 2. It's a very original name. Now, quickly, we only have one material, so everything I do on layer 2 will be black, right? But take a look. If I create another material, and let's make this fuchsia, hot pink, okay? Now we have this material selected. We have our fuchsia material selected on our layer 2, which means, okay, there we go. There's our fuchsia line. Now because it's this black material is also on layer 2, anything I do will be on top of it. But now if I come back to the black layer, on layer 2, you can see that it'll go over the fuchsia. Okay, this is just like you're painting on a canvas. You can put layers on top of layers, but they're all on the same layer. So if I go and hide this, you can see I've hid layer 2. Now, one thing that's kind of important. Now we've got our fuchsia layer selected. Layer 2 is on top of layer 1. And you can see right there that I prove it to you, okay? Because the fuchsia layer is on top of our line layer. And this can get, you want to keep this as separated as possible because we might be doing granular stuff, right? We're going to do our line art, and then underneath that, we're going to put our fills, and we're going to have a couple different fill colors in there, and then we'll have a background. And so layers, are important, as are the materials that we use to animate our layers, okay? And layers, if we switch these right here, then look what happens. Okay, now the line layer, our initial layer, is on top of our layer 2, because over here you can see that our line layer is now above our second layer. And think of the layers like a fossil record, right? Where the newest is on top. The top layer is the newest. So that's going to be on top. And then as we go back into deep time, we hit different fossil layers. We go all the way back to the Cambrian explosion. Okay, so that's just a quick one-twosy on layers. You can get rid of them just by clicking that. And then we got the eraser over here. See, here's our erase tool, and we just click and drag. Now, it didn't take away all of it. You can see because I have strength set to halvesies, but if we pump the strength up to hundo, if we pump the strength up to full power, switch our lasers from stun, we get rid of all of it, okay? So I'm gonna click back over here to draw, and I'm going to bring my radius down to find a radius that I like. This is to taste, you guys. I'm also going to get rid of, I don't need to get rid of this material, but I'll change it to something else. I'm going to go back to black. If you want to outline your buffalo or whatever animal you're rotoscoping, if you want that to be fuchsia, you go right ahead. Go right ahead. I'm not here to judge. You want a hot pink buffalo? That's on you, baby. You are only bound by your own limits of creativity. I'm not going to put the restrictor plates on you. If you want a fuchsia buffalo, you go right ahead. Okay, let's get going. We got the line layer first, and we're going to make a line right here, and that's a little too thin for me, so I'm going to control Z out of that, and let's pump it up to 45, and let's see how this works. You know what? I'm all right with that. Okay, so we're ready to begin. I got my strength at onesies. I got a radius of 45 on my line right here. Ink pen, I'm gonna go ink pen rough. You can go ink pen smooth. We talked, these are up here. These are the types of drawing tools you have at the ready. You can also find new and inventive ones online. There's plugins to add, you know, you can draw butterfly patterns if you want. Like, you can find a bunch of really neat tools to put up here. And then the stroke, you can stabilize the stroke. And if you're using your mouse, that's probably a good idea. And you can drag this up as high or as low as you want. And with that out of the way, let's get going. To move around, I'm shift middle mousing right here. Shift middle mouse, it lets you pan. Okay, like pan the man. And all we're gonna do is just trace. Okay, that's it. That's all we're gonna do. All right, nothing major. We're just gonna trace around the shape of our buffalo. Okay, I'm gonna pan this way. And this is rotoscoping, you guys. This is how so many of the greatest animated films of all time came into be, right? We talked about this earlier. Jiminy Cricket was rotoscoped. Snow White was rotoscoped. The magic fairy, the fairy god, no, no, it was a fairy god, who was the woman that made Pinocchio a real boy? She was a fairy of some kind. I don't know if she was a fairy godmother, but she was definitely a magical princess. She showed up after Pinocchio very valiantly gave his life to rescue his father from the belly of a whale. I hope everyone can see the allegory in that. The son that dies to rescue the father. That's got some pretty heavy Christian connotations with that. But really all myth, right? You know, you rescue your culture from the belly of an angry whale. It's the hero's journey, you guys. And I forget her name, but she really had a Glinda the Good Witch kind of vibe about her. Her name may have even been Glenda. I don't even know if she had a name. Anyway, she was rotoscoped. That's what I'm trying to say right here. Okay. So there's our shape. There's our figure. And now let's get this horn in here like this. Like that. And then let's add some detail around the muscles, you know? And I'm gonna turn my stroke off for this. I'm gonna turn my stroke stabilizer off for this, just because it really adds it adds a much looser feeling to the stroke to be, you know, you got this, and these are really just, and this is, so right here, this is why you want a stylus, because I put pressure on my pen, and there's several marks, or I put heavy pressure on my pen, and it's a much thicker mark. Okay, and this is... we're just adding some tone right here. Okay, just these are just basic crosshatches. Nothing you haven't seen before. Unless you haven't seen crosshatching before, in which case, welcome to drawing 101. These are technically just hatches. A crosshatch would be something like that. Okay, so we're just making a couple of lines that, and I'm essentially outlining. This'll help transition when we do full colors. Okay, because obviously this area will be very dark, this area will be very light, and this area that we're doing right now will essentially, it'll be the transition zone, right? Kind of the line of demarcation from darks to lights. And it'll make each individual cell unique, right? I say cell. That's what they used to be called in the olden days of animations, right? The hand-drawn cells, which you can still buy. If there are any art collectors out there, then you probably know about that. They're also called frames. Okay. Can't really see a mouth down here. That's unfortunate. We might have to give them eyes later. Maybe the eye. I'm gonna have to look and see if the eye is down here or up here. Do we give him cartoon eyes, or do we just keep it very dark and mysterious? He's a mysterious buffalo. He's running, but what is he running? Is he running from something? Is he running? Maybe he's running. Maybe he's been running from something so much and so often that he didn't even realize he was running toward something. Yeah, I said it. Okay, then we'll come down here. And we'll give a little hoof definition. Again, the bison. Bison's got a closer hoof to the horse than the cow, but it looked like the European water buffalo, which is why early American naturalists gave it the name buffalo, even though genetically it is nothing like this at all. One thing you can do is we can go into sculpt mode. And check this out. So you can push. You can kind of push your line up. So all I did was come up here. We were in draw mode. Now we're in sculpt mode. And if you want it to be kind of spot on to your form, we got his junk down here. And then you can kind of push your lines around. So you don't have to worry about being too precise because we can fix that in post, right? Just have some fun. We're going to come back into draw, and you know what? Let's give a, let's do the ground as well. That's a good idea. So I'll turn, I'm going to turn my stroke stabilizer back on, and let's work on here, and because he's on something. Oh, you know what? Let's bump this up a little bit. So there's a little bit of difference between what he's on, between the ground moving, because the ground's going to be moving underneath his, underneath the thundering herd, right? Right? And you can be as detailed with this as you want to. We're just creating a little shadow under here. Because this will give the illusion that he's moving through space. In time, because there's light hitting him, obviously, which means there's a shadow somewhere, unless the light is directly over him, in which the shadow would be directly under him, because he's big buffalo. All right, so we're just making some shadows right here. Okay. You can see we're being loose with it. All right, we're not trying to get crazy with this. We don't need to be crazy with this. We're trying to have some fun with this, you guys. I'm gonna shift middle mouse to get back here a little bit, and then I'm gonna bring my radius down a little bit. We're just making some marks, you guys. And this does look arbitrary, and that's okay. And then let's get some back here. Like that. Get some like that. Get some like that. Let's shift metal mouse this way. Okay, and now I'm just very thinly drawing this line right here, and this is one of the, this is why a stylus is a good idea, because it's pressure sensitive. So the more pressure you put on your lines, the thicker the lines are going to be. Whereas with a mouse, I think it's just one click fits all. So it'll be harder to get that to get that, you know, that thinness of that line back there. Okay. You know, I thought about just making it one small line, or excuse me, one straight line, but it was like, how natural is that going to be? And you know what we might do as a bonus, if there's time, I'm just kidding, there's going to be time, I just might not even want. What we might do is create, like, we'll have him running a bunch, and then we can, we can put, you know, after we create our buffalo running, what we can do is we'll make another, I don't know, like a tiny little mountain, or maybe one of those really neat hoodoos from Bryce Canyon. You know what? That's a great idea. We'll do a hoodoo from Bryce Canyon, because hoodoos are the coolest, man. Anyway, let's just come back here. We're hatching some mid-tones, okay? We're hatching some transitions, some tonal transitions, right? That's really all we're doing. And we're having fun with it. And what we're ensuring is that, you know, the next frame is not, will not have these hatches in the exact same spot, so it'll give the illusion of movement, which is what we want, because that's all animation is. It's all video is, really. It's just a series of images, one on top of the other, sequentially. You know, there's more to it, obviously. I guess that'd be the art. That's like saying all painting is just, you know, it's just. All the Mona Lisa is just paint on a canvas, right? That's technically all it is. But you know, it's much more than that, right? Get some hair going, you know, we'll get one of these and get some hooves. You know what? I'm gonna give him some fuzz on top of his dome up here. Bring this down. We got the stroke stabilizer off, and then let's give my guy some hair up here, right? He's a buffalo. He's a wild buffalo. And he's got some fur. Okay? He's furry. Buffaloes are awesome. And I could be calling him bison, but I'm not. Do you hear me? All you Linnaean scientists out there, call it a buffalo. Why not? I mean, why not? Why you're doubling down on bison? You couldn't even call it a bison buffalo? I think that's nonsense. I'm just saying, you catch more flies with sugar than honey. Bees with sugar than honey. You catch insects with sweetness is the overarching point I'm trying to say. And guys, if you're trying to make every stroke I'm trying to make, you're doing it wrong, okay? And I hope you pick that up, that I'm going at a pace that you can follow, but I'm being loose enough and free enough to kind of force you to have to do it yourself. And I hope that's coming through. Truly I do. You know, you're going to have to make your own marks. And the point is to make a fun little animation by way of rotoscoping, which again, if copying existing footage is good enough for Disney, it's good enough for us. And that's exactly what Disney did for generations, y'all. Rotoscoping was the way, Mandalorian style, like this is the way, okay? Okay, with our work saved. There we go. We've done it. We have succeeded in our task. Okay. We're going to come over here. We got our grease pencil selected. Grease pencil layer selected. Perfect. That's all we're looking for. We come right here. We got our line layer. And you see this right here? This here, this is important. We get this is our dope sheet, okay? And dope sheet is just a fancy way of saying place where the keyframes hide. These are called keyframes. This yellow kind of diamond that's highlighted. And on this keyframe is our drawing, okay? And it's just an outline, and that's fine. Don't even worry about it. We'll add color to the buffalo later. For the time being, we're going to move one frame in our animation. See, this says first frame of the playback. You see my mouse down here? We got start and we got end. Now, at 24 frames per second, this is just over a 10-second animation. So let's make this even and call it a 10-second animation. And if anybody is curious as to how I got that, just do some basic math. 240 total frames divided by 24 equals 10. So there's 10 seconds at 24 frames a second, totaling 240 frames, okay? And each one of these frames up here, these are not seconds up here, super important. Each one of these here is a frame, but we're not going to animate every single frame, okay? Because the eye just doesn't pick it up. It really doesn't matter. It's moving too fast to be able to pick that up. Okay, we started on the one, and that's cool. That's no problem. We're going to move two. So we're going to go 1, 2 to the third frame. Now, check it. All we have to do is start drawing. If I put my pen down here, look at that. I got a new keyframe. Okay. Now, this green stuff is the onion. Okay, and the onion is just a way to see where my previous drawings were. I've essentially created a new keyframe. Okay, all I had to do was draw. And so now these circles are the only thing that'll be on my drawing moving forward. This kind of neon green stuff is the onion skin of a previous cell frame drawing. And moving forward, if I hit play, you're only going to see the most recent drawing come through. Okay? Are you with me? I hope so. That may have been confusing. So let's control Z out of this. Okay? And this is our drawing right here. This is what we just did. And if we don't do anything else, then this one drawing will stay on our animation the whole rest of the way. Okay? But we obviously don't want that. So, we're going to move up 2. 1, 2. Okay, you can click and drag. That's cool. That's no problem. You can also move your frames over here. See, this clicks it up. You can go to the specific frame. If you're too zoomed out, that might be an issue. So just zoom in and then you'll be able to see it frame by frame. So this is a key frame. We've keyed in a drawing on this frame. In traditional animation, it's called a cell. A lot of times you can hear those two words used interchangeably. Some people want to be a snob about it and say, actually, it's pronounced this way. Just ignore those people because they're the worst. So I'm going to move. You can either click and drag, or you can move your frames over here. Okay, so I'm going to move 2 frames up because we animate on the 2s. Okay, we started on 0. 0 is not a number, technically. It's a unit. It's more of a placeholder. Thank you, India. Gifted humanity, the 0. So, hat tip, India. I appreciate you for your contributions to mankind. Also, the Kama Sutra was awesome. And that's just, I mean, you want to talk about a rich culture. The same culture that gave you, you know, one of math's most crucial advancement also gave you a book on how to do the sex in a bunch of wild and inventive ways. Like, hat tip, you guys. Well done. That's just range, you know? It's thinking outside the box. It's like, I mean, the French can't boast that. French are good at, like, 3 things. Mimes, good wine, and surrendering in major wars. But you know, that's not range, you know? India's got some range. So hat tip, Indians. And Let's get back to it. Zero. We're not going to start on zero because zero is not a number. One is a number. Zero is the absence of a number. Yeah, man. You dig? Put some shades on that. So we're gonna animate on the twos, which puts us on the three. Now, you can come right here, and you can copy this, and then if I come right here, and you can paste it. Okay. So now this keyframe is this keyframe. If you want to start with this keyframe, if you want to draw a fresh one, you go right ahead. But I don't really want to just now. I'm going to come up here to my Muy Bridge frames. And what are we going to do to frame one? Because it's done, we're going to hide it. Okay. Now, take a look. We can start fresh, but do we need to? I don't think we need to, you guys. Like, let's look. We already got, this is pretty good right here. Our back leg is moving. Our third leg is moving. Our front right leg, arm, is moving. So we got some stuff to tweak, but the majority of what we're doing and working with is already done, has been done for us, which I think is just super. You know, just looking at the time, I think we should stop this video here. In the next video, we're going to pick up exactly where we left off. Okay, we're going to do this step by step. I am with you. I will not leave you. We're going to get through this step by step, but you know what? We've just been sitting for a while. So let's stand up and let's do a quick stretch and a bend and then come right back to it. And we're going to pick up exactly where we left off. Okay. I'll see you in the next one.